Good evening and welcome to this edition of News Leader. I'm Andrew Todd. In tonight's news, we have highlights from Tullahoma's Little Miss Tullahoma pageant, Lane Curley makes a decision on running for mayor, and TDOT is steadily working to repair potholes from the winter's damage. We'll have all these stories and more on tonight's News Leader.
Hi, my name is Ringo. Here at Barkview Senior Living, they're human-friendly. That's why I love it here, and so does my senior human. When they want a bite, they get chef-prepared meals, and so do I. Movies in the theater, day trips, walks on the trail, and other senior humans to play with. The grass and the grounds are exquisite. It's everything my human needs to be healthy and active. Barkview. A Parkview Senior Living. For your dog's best friend, you.
Hi, I'm Terry Stroop with Stroop's Accurate Refrigeration, your number one hometown HVAC company. We offer dependable and reliable service on all your HVAC equipment. We also offer high-efficiency trained cooling units. Call us for your cooling needs. Your comfort is what we do.
It's summer, call Stroop's.
We teach Parkinson's patients how to move big and not let the Parkinson's slow them down. I've had patients I've treated in-house that could not even stand up, could not roll over in the bed, left the facility walking with a walker, have come back to us as an outpatient and continued their big program and are now completely, you know, handling life. The success of the program is just phenomenal.
Let us champion your recovery. Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
Welcome back. At Saturday's Miss Tullahoma pageant, Reagan Brazier took home the crown for Little Miss Tullahoma. Let's watch Reagan and her court as they're crowned and her interview with Candy Couch.
All the young ladies will return to the stage. They are all adorable and brave. Let's give them another round of applause for their courage and poise. I will now announce your 2024 Little Miss Tullahoma and her court. Fourth runner-up, number two, Anlyn Reese Harper. Runner-up, number five, Gianna May Panko. Second runner-up, number three, McKinley Preston Hall. First runner-up, number one, Marin Bailey Mabe. Now, the 2024 Little Miss Tullahoma is contestant number eight, Reagan Grace Brazier. Congratulations. the new Little Miss Tullahoma. We'll take a walk. Our 2024 Little Miss Tullahoma and her court.
Well, folks, I am here with our new Little Miss Tullahoma and my friend, Reagan Grace Brazier. We're so proud of you.
Thank you.
Yes. Well, tell the folks how old you are.
Six.
Six. And where do you go to school?
Robert E. Lee.
Does that mean you're in the first grade?
No.
You're
kindergarten.
Kindergarten. Okay. Well, that's great. Well, tell me, what do you like to do?
I like to do specials.
Do specials?
Yeah.
Well, what's a special? Tell me what's a special.
Well, it's like
car. Well, I know one thing I know you like to do is ride in the golf cart with your granddaddy, right?
Mm-hmm.
And where do you go when you're on the golf cart with your granddaddy?
Your house?
My house, that's right, that's right. I love that. Yes, well, tell me, do you have brothers and sisters? Actually,
yes.
I know, but I want you to tell everybody.
Yes.
What do you have? Tell us what you have.
I have a sister and a brother.
Yes. I know they're excited and proud of you. You bet. Mm-hmm. And what are you getting ready to do right now that's real exciting?
I'm going to move to a different house.
Yeah? You're going to be doing what?
I'm going to move into a different
house. She's moving to a different house. That's right. And she's so excited about that. It's going to be really nice. Bet you'll have your own room and everything, won't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Well, is there anything you'd like to tell the folks out here about yourself? No? Well, I'll tell you what, she never, ever, ever, not one time, quit smiling the whole time she was on the stage. She is like a ray of sunshine everywhere she goes. So we're real proud of her, and we congratulate you and wish you well being Little Miss Tullahoma, okay?
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Give them a wave. Can you wave to the folks? Okay. Thank you, Reagan. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
And we'll have Senior Miss Tullahoma on Tuesday's news. After these messages, we'll be right back.
We tend to lose our motivation when we have something that's chronic, but you've got to do what you can early on as you can. After I'd exercise like that, I would have a lot of energy to do housework or whatever I needed.
Well, I would recommend it highly to anyone at any degree of Parkinson.
Let us champion your recovery. Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
Hi, I'm Terry Stroop with Stroop's Accurate Refrigeration, your number one hometown HVAC company. We offer dependable and reliable service on all your HVAC equipment. We also offer high-efficiency trained cooling units. Call us for your cooling needs. Your comfort is what we do.
It's summer!
Parkview Senior Living, active, independent senior living at its finest.
Welcome back. Tullahoma's former mayor and founder of the News Leader, Lane Curley, has made it clear that he won't be throwing his hat into the mayoral race this time around, despite widespread encouragement from the community. After reflecting on the matter, Curley decided it was best for himself and his family to step back from the spotlight that comes with public office, especially after 31 years of serving, 18 of which were as mayor. He expressed gratitude for the support he's received, but emphasized the need to prioritize his family's well-being. Curley's decision not to run is rooted in his belief that the city deserves better than the current state of affairs. He noted the dysfunction within the Board of Mayor and Aldermen and the longing among citizens for a return to civility and productivity in city governance. Despite stepping away from the political arena, Curley remains committed to serving Tullahoma through philanthropic endeavors like the Reading Buddies program, showcasing his ongoing dedication to the community's well-being. Reflecting on his time as mayor, Curley highlighted the progress made during his tenure, including Tullahoma's recognition as a top micropolitan city in the state and improvements in quality of life. He also outlined the qualities he believes are essential in a mayor: compassion for all residents, leadership skills, and a commitment to fostering positive change. Curley expressed concern about the negativity pervading recent BMA meetings and its impact on citizens' lives, urging for a return to civil discourse. To gauge public sentiment, Curley conducted a survey which revealed dissatisfaction with the current BMA and significant support for his potential candidacy. However, despite not running, he remains willing to assist the incoming mayor and encourages citizens to reach out with their feedback and concerns. Well, maybe next time. Tennessee Department of Transportation crews continue working around the clock, repairing potholes along interstates and state routes caused by January's record winter storm. Statewide effort is using all available resources, including contact crews, to repair the damaged areas as quickly as possible. TDOT has laid more than double the amount of mix this January and February compared to the same time last year. As weather permits, TDOT will continue repairing the roads over the coming days and weeks. More permanent repairs will be made in the spring and early summer when asphalt plants are regularly producing hot mix. Full-scale paving may be necessary in some locations. Drivers should be prepared for short-term traffic delays during these pothole repair operations. While every effort will be made to perform repairs during off-peak travel times, 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. weekdays, some lane closures may extend into the late afternoon, evening, and weekends. Drivers are asked to be patient and to watch out for TDOT crews on interstates and state highways. Move over and slow down. Drivers can report potholes by calling TDOT Fix hotline at 833-TDOT-FIX. Stay with us. More news is coming up in just a moment.
It's not invoice. It's not MSRP. It's not Christmas Day, although it may feel like it. It's the lowest prices in Middle Tennessee, period. Get to Stan McNabb Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram or Stan McNabb Chevrolet Buick GMC Cadillac before these prices are gone forever.
He's a little bit of you, he's a little bit of me. He's the trash along the roadside of Tennessee. He's the garbage that we pack. He's the dream we left behind. Lord, there ain't no lower class than Tennessee trash. A throwaway bottle or a pop top can may not seem much to a traveling man, but a little bit of litter goes a long, long way.
We have met the enemy, and he is us.
Welcome back. In this episode of County Mayor Judd Matheny's Mayor's Message, Judd sits down with one of Tullahoma's county commissioners, Lynn Seaborn.
Hello, I'm Coffee County Mayor Judd Matheny, and welcome to another edition of Mayor's Message. This one's especially special for me because I have somebody that I look up to greatly, and I have for many, many years. I have the greatest respect for this gentleman next to me, Lynn Seaborn, and not only because he's such a terrific gentleman and American, but the things he does for this country, the things he does for this county, the things he's done for me personally and politically over the years, the confidant he's been to so many people, it has meant so much. And just can't say enough positive things about
you. You're building me way too much here.
It's true. And plus, he's my only real friend that's a real rocket scientist, you know, which is really cool. But Lynn, as always, we like to have our commissioners and some of our employees. We're trying to get to more and more people in the county in these episodes.
Yep.
We'd like for you, in your own words, to tell the viewers here in Coffee County why you're in politics. Also, maybe a little bit about what committees you serve on, which you carry a lot of hats, wear a lot of hats. And then we can maybe talk about what you like to do in the real world and things. And you're extraordinarily busy, so
I'm too busy.
Resting is probably right.
Maybe I should quit one of these. Which one should I quit?
Oh, man. No. Well, I get you, but go ahead, sir.
So as far as how I got started in this stuff, I remember being interested in politics even as a little kid. The earliest political memory I have is Nixon being impeached, or not impeached, but Nixon resigning. Yeah. And what I remember about that was my parents being mad because that was back when there was only three stations on TV, and we had 2.5 stations because we couldn't hardly get the third one. And Watergate was on TV every night, and we couldn't watch our regular TV shows. That's what everybody remembers about Watergate. I don't know if you remember that or not.
Oh, yeah. It seems like small potatoes now compared to what's going on.
Yeah. but I remember that. And I remember in fifth grade, it was an election year. I think it was Jimmy Carter, and I can't remember now who Jimmy Carter ran against in his first. Was that
Ford?
The Ford-Carter election, and we had mock election in fifth grade. I remember that. My parents were Republicans, and I was one of the only people that voted for Ford because it was farm country, and everybody wanted to vote for the farmer. But anyway, I got started on the Planning Commission in Tullahoma a long time ago now, and that kind of got me interested in local growth, and being an engineer, you kind of tend to think towards the future and planning and everything. And so we set up I got asked to help set up an economic development board in the city of Tullahoma. So we did that like 15 years ago now, 12, 15 years ago. And so getting involved with that really opened my eyes to the growth that was coming to the county and everything. And so that's why I ran for county commission, is aside from the fact that Rush Brickin asked me to run when he left his seat to go be a state rep. But at that time, it was clear to me there's a lot of planning that needed to be done for the county. So that's how I ended up over on the county commission. And now we've done some planning committee stuff.
Oh, you have.
And we're trying to make progress there.
Well, he's our chairman of our budget and finance committee. He's also was chairman and still is chairman of our strategic planning committee. And they just finished their final report and briefed us on it a short couple of months ago. And it gives us some firm marching orders to move forward with a lot of things in this county that should have been done maybe in other areas already. And some of the major recommendations, if I may, are, you know, we need to update our planning and our zoning and our land use maps and things like that for a more modern society. We need to beef up some of our agencies here, put some more people in to help with some of our institutions here. There's a whole lot of utilities out in the rural areas that need to be looked at also, water and wastewater and things like that. You've worked with federal governments and local city governments to do some planning and some merging of some ideas, and all this has kind of been boiled down to give us a good place to start. Really, how are we going to tackle all these growth problems and do it in an orderly way and start organizing our commission to do that? And you led that whole effort.
I appreciate that. Yeah, it was a lot of fun doing that. We tried to meet with every stakeholder we could in the county. And, you know, over in Tullahoma, I live in Tullahoma, and representative from that district. And we've been having a lot of discussion about the growth coming in Tullahoma, and people are always scared of that, right? And some people don't want change. And we had some folks out there saying, well, I saw some folks online saying, well, we're going to keep Tullahoma just like it is. I made a presentation about that to the Rotary Club a few months back. I said, the problem with that is that Tullahoma has never been the way it is, mm-hmm. right? There's always been change. My office, I work for engineering firm I3, and we're right downtown next to the railroad track, so I get the railroad trains every day.
I get used to it after a while.
My office is sitting there in an odd little office building, and I saw a thing on Facebook. You know, you see everything on Facebook about history of Tullahoma. Well, my office is sitting where there used to be a grocery store, but before that, there was a theater there, and it wasn't the Marshall Theater. I didn't even know it, but there was another theater sitting at that location way back in a long time ago. And, you know, I'm a block away from the Studebaker dealership there in Tullahoma. And so it's easy to say that we don't want to see change, but the reality is change is coming whether we like it or not. So we just got to do what we can to get ready for it.
That's right. You have to dance with it and not against it. And so, of course, we know you're very busy in the county government. We thank you for that. Yeah. You've been a great public servant. You're very busy at work all the time. When you do get some free time, what do you like to do? What are your hobbies?
I tried to do some things whether I have free time or not. One of the things my family and I have been involved with over the years is the South Jacksonville's Country Show. So if you hadn't been to South Jacksonville's Country, come see the show. Probably been doing that over 20 years. Very active in our church, Westwood Church of Christ, down on West Lincoln. I like to read and do some music and stuff like that. Don't do music quite as well as I'd like, and I like to get out and hike around, fish, and hunt a little bit. I'm not a big hunter, but I pretend. So.
Oh, very cool. Well, you're in a great place to hike and fish, for sure.
Yep.
You are. Well, man, you'll be able to see Lynn's contact information up here, obviously, Dr. Seaborn and Commissioner Seaborn from Tullahoma. And he'll have his email and his name and his district, and you can always reach him that way. As always, you can reach me at 931-723-5100, and I can get a message to Lynn. If you have any ideas for our strategic planning, for our budget committee, anything, feel free to pass those on to us. We always like to see you at our meetings live and in person. But if you can't make it, we're on Coffee County Government YouTube channel, all of our meetings. You can see Lynn's budget meetings. You can see him in the full commission. And his strategic planning meetings are all online, just where you watch this show. Doctor, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
And as always, thank you for watching this edition of The Mayor's Message, and we'll see you next week.
We'll be right back after these messages.
I had a knee replacement, so they've got me in life care, which I'm very, very thankful for. I couldn't garden. I couldn't do my flower beds. I can't chase my little dogs. I have been in several therapy sessions for knees and back, and that's the best therapist I believe I've ever been to. It's tremendous because I'm able to walk again, but if it wasn't for the care, I wouldn't be where I am.
Let us champion your recovery. Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
Hi, I'm Fran Gray with Alzheimer's Tennessee. When you receive a diagnosis of Alzheimer's disease for yourself or someone you love, please know that you do not have to go through this journey alone. Alzheimer's Tennessee is here for you to provide support and education, all the help you may need to get through this challenge. Our number is 931-434-2348. We encourage you to give us a call. We're here to help.
Welcome back. With spring trying to peek out at us, we're all ready to head out into the beautiful area around us. This video was sent to us by the Tennessee State Parks Department detailing a day in the life of an interpretive park ranger.
Hi everybody, my name is Ashlyn Walker and I'm an SIR at Seven Island State Birding Park in Knox County, Tennessee. I'm also a student. I'm studying conservation biology at Lincoln Memorial University, and I'm super lucky to have this experience while still being in school. SIR stands for Seasonal Interpretive Recreator, and it is a seasonal position that takes place from mid-May through Labor Day in September. A lot of people don't know what interpreter means in my job title, and the best way that I like to explain it is that sometimes our science talk can sound like a foreign language to guests. It's important for us to remember that not everyone has a background in science or history, so it's important that we meet people where they are, especially when we're working with children. So my job specifically relates to programming, and the goal is to reach as many people as possible. We want to get people outside for them to learn and care about conservation and to have wonderful experiences connecting them to the outdoors because it relates to our mission in Tennessee State Parks. For programming this year, I have done lots of frog walks where we talk about the different types of frogs and amphibians here at the park. I've spent a lot of time with a spotting scope, which is essentially a telescope that we can put our cameras on to see wildlife from far away. Plenty of kids programming. We've done junior ranger activities, river explorations, story times, you name it. And plenty of adult programs too. I've done a habitat hike where we learn about how the different habitats support different types of birds within the park. I've done some beginner photography and even some beginner birding stuff because I'm very much a beginner birder myself. My favorite thing about programming is sharing my passion with others. It really makes my day to see people just signing up for programs because I know that they're taking an initiative in learning. I love to see their faces light up when they learn cool things about the outdoors, especially when I'm working with the kids. Public outreach is a huge step in conservation, and I'm just so thankful to be a part of it this summer. Alongside programming, I also have many other duties. Because Seven Islands has such a very small staff, we like to say that every job is everyone's job, except law enforcement, of course. There is always something to be done, and every single day is different. Between programs, I spend time completing the other needed tasks. This could be cleaning restrooms, weed eating, removing invasives, working on future programs. There's always something to be done. The job is not always glamorous, but we did not sign up for that. One of my favorite things about working at Seven Islands is that I have learned so much while being here. I have gotten to observe and participate in research. I have been trained in bird handling, and I have gotten to see what life might be like as a ranger. I feel like I learn something new every single day from staff, volunteers, and sometimes even guests. I've also gotten to experience wildlife in ways that I never have before. If you think you may have a future in conservation or Tennessee State Parks, I highly recommend that you apply, because I am so thankful to have this experience as a student.
Stay with us. Your weather forecast is coming up after these messages.
For many senior citizens, life looks like this, but it doesn't have to. When you make your home at Parkview Senior Living, life after retirement takes on a whole new meaning. Daily exercise options, fun outings, happy hour, game nights, movies and popcorn, arts and crafts, enjoying friends over chef-prepared meals. Parkview Senior Living, where you're always home, but you're never home alone.
Hi, I'm Terry Stroop with Stroop's Accurate Refrigeration, your number one hometown HVAC company. We offer dependable and reliable service on all your HVAC equipment. We also offer high-efficiency trained cooling units. Call us for your cooling needs. Your comfort is what we do.
It's summer, call Stroop.
Welcome back. We'll take a look at your weather at this time, starting with your weather history on this date. Our record high was in 2012 at 82 degrees. Record low was in 1993 at 6 degrees. The average high for this day is 60, and the average low is 38. Heavy rain moving in tonight with a low of 60. Heavy rain expected for Friday with a high of 68 and a low of 48. Mostly sunny skies for Saturday with a high of 65 and a low of 45. And that's our news leader report for this evening. We invite you to join us each Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday evenings at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. for News Leader. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook and YouTube. Stay safe. Have a great evening.